Good morning, students of Standard 11. Today we are going to discuss topic morphology and anatomy of earthworm from chapter 7, structural organization in animals. Earthworm. It is dorsoventrally round. So students, earthworm actually belongs to a phyla Annelida, and which is dorsoventrally round, that is round from the front and round from the back. There is presence of rings in earthworm which divide the body of earthworm in various compartments. It can range from 110 to 120 in number. So students, if you concentrate on this picture, you can easily notice there are presence of huge number of rings which are present on the earthworm, and these rings can range from 110 to 120 in number, and which divide the whole body of the earthworm into various compartments. The anterior part of the body segment consists of prostomium and peristomium. So students, if you concentrate on this picture, then you will be able to notice that the anterior part of the body segment comprises of prostomium and peristomium. So students, here this is the prostomium part, which is the outermost part of the earthworm, and here which you can see the first ring like structure of the body segment of earthworm, which is called as peristomium. So students, peristomium and prostomium forms the lesions of the mouth in the earthworm. Clitellum, which is a dark band of glandular tissue, is found in the 14th and the 16th segment of earthworm. So students, clitellum, which is the identifying feature of the earthworm, is actually a dark band of glandular tissues. That is, here there are presence of huge number of glands, and which remains generally present in the 14th to 16th segment of the earthworm. So students, here you can notice this structure, which is dark band and comprising of huge glandular tissues, are called as the clitellum. The spermatheceal aperture is present in between 5 to 9 segment of earthworm, and female genital pore is present in 14th segment. So students, the male reproductive organ generally remains present in between the 5th to 9th segment of the earthworm, and the female reproductive organ or hole generally represents and remains located on the 14th segment of the earthworm. Cetae is short, thin thread-like structure present in every segment except certain segments like clitellum, which is used for locomotion. So students, cetae is actually a short, that is very small, thin thread-like structures which is generally present in every segment or compartment of the earthworm, except certain segments, which are the clitellum. So in CT is actually used for the locomotion. That is, the earthworm utilizes the CT to move from one place to another. Anatomy of earthworm. The elementary canal of earthworm comprises of various parts. So students, the elementary canal of the earthworm has various parts present in it. The mouth of earthworm is located in first to third segment. So students, the mouth of the earthworm is generally located in between the first to third segment. So students, the esophagus generally remains present in between the fifth to sixth segment of the earthworm. So students, if you notice here, then this is the fifth to the sixth segment where there is presence of the esophagus. A muscular gizzard is located in 8th to 9th segment. In between 8th to 9th segment, the main function of which is to grind. So students, a muscular gizzard is located in between the 8th to 9th segment of the earthworm, and the main function of which is to grind. So students, if you concentrate, you can notice here that gizzard is present here, and the segment where it remains present is in between 8 to 9 segment. So that is the gizzard, and the main function of which is to grind the food. Stomach, which is the site for digestion of ingested food, is located in between 9th to 14th segment. Calciferous gland helps in digestion. Calciferous gland help in digestion. So students, we can say calciferous glands help in the digestion of food. So students, calciferous glands are the most important feature of the stomach. Intestine is found extended from 15th segment to last segment of earthworm. So students, intestine extends from the 15th segment to the last segment of the earthworm. So students, in this picture, if you will concentrate, you will be able to notice that the intestine starts from the 15th segment and moves to the lower regions of the earthworm. So students, this is the region from 1 to 14, and in between this 1 to 14 region or 1 to 14 segment, intestine does not remain present. But after the 15th segment, which starts from here, there is presence of intestine. There is presence of paired intestinal cecum arising from 26th segment. So students, here you can notice the paired structure which arises from the intestinal region located in the 26th segment and which is in pair. So you can easily notice here, students, there are presence of two intestinal cecae which is remains present on the 26th segment. The distinct feature of intestine is presence of typhlosole, which is found located after 26th segment and increases the absorptive surface area. So students, the most important feature of the intestine is that there is presence of typhlosole, which is present located in the 26th segment and the main function of which is to increase the absorptive surface area. So students, if you concentrate here, then you can notice that there is presence of typhlosole and which increases the absorptive surface area of the small intestine. Circulation of blood in earth form. There is presence of certain blood vessels which comprise circulatory system of earth form and are as follows. So students, the circulation of blood in earth form comprises of certain very important blood vessels which are dorsal vessel, ventral vessel and lateral esophageal vessel. So students, these three important vessels form the circulatory system of blood in earth form. Dorsal vessel carries blood from posterior region to anterior region, whereas ventral vessel carries blood from anterior region to posterior region. So students, here we can notice that the dorsal region, dorsal vessel, which you can see here if you concentrate on this picture, and it carries the blood from the posterior region. So students, this is the posterior region. So from the posterior region it carries the blood to the anterior region, and there is also a presence of ventral vessels too, which carries the blood from the anterior region to the posterior region. Lateral hood is present in the 7th and 9th segment, and lateral esophageal hood remains present in the 12th and 13th segment. So students, hood allows the conduction of blood from dorsal to ventral vessel. So students, let's understand the exact location of various types of hood which remain present in the earthworm. So students, there are mainly two different types of hood which remain present in the earthworm. That's the lateral hood and the lateral esophageal hood. The lateral hood, which you can notice here, remains present in the 7th and the 9th segment, which is also mentioned here, you can see. And the lateral esophageal hood remains present in the 12th and 13th segment. So students, here you can see the lateral esophageal hood remains present and which is present in the 12th and the 13th segment. And both of these two carries blood from the dorsal to the ventral surface. Students, now let's discuss a very important question. What are various blood vessels in the circulation of blood? The following are the blood vessels in the circulation of blood in earthworm: dorsal vessel, ventral vessel and lateral esophageal vessel. Thank you, students.